detachment!
Unbelievable. Miss Edie, you got us all separated from the squad.
Excuse me? What part of this is my fault?
Maybe the part where you ran after those imps, screaming like a banshee.
Well, what about Marina then? She ran off after that silly puppy, didn't she?
So cute.
Now, let's stop assigning blame and think of what to do next, shall we?
You're right. Lieutenant Gunther's orders over the wireless were to rejoin the squad ASAP. That battle was all over the place. We probably weren't the only ones separated.
Of course we weren't! Now, let's hurry along back! They're all waiting for us!
Because you ran off. Don't forget that part.
Oh!
I like your right cross best, but that left hook.
Oh, honey, don't let her get you down. Must be tough, though, playing Whippin' Boy.
Don't worry, Jan. Whippin' Boy suits me just fine.
You're colorful as ever, Homer.
Ignore him! And where are we anyway? I can't see a thing in this dark.
There are houses up ahead. A village.
Maybe I should thank that puppy. I'm glad to have your eyes here, Marina.
Do you suppose we could sneak in a quick bath in town?
Ooh! Count me in, too. I'm getting to feel like a muskox here.
Have you two lost your minds? We need to get back to the squad before...
Eek! What was that? An explosion? Where?
Marina!
Imperials. No doubt about it. They're attacking the village. There's a tank, too. Was probably the explosion we heard.
We have to help them!
Miss Eden.
I'm saying we should go help that village!
But they have tanks. The difference in our firepower is too great.
Don't give me difference in firepower! If we don't help them, that village will be wiped clean off the map! If we can't beat them outright, we can at least buy the villagers time to get out!
What? No, I didn't know you got this worked up.
What are you talking about? I'll have you know I'm perfectly calm right now!
It's nothing to deny, hon. I like a little fire in a soldier.
But are you sure we should, Miss Edie? Our orders are to return to the squad ASAP.
Oh, to hell with our orders, Homer! Why do you think we're fighting this war? Because of our orders? Of course not! We're fighting to protect people like these, am I right? I'm not about to walk on by after seeing a defenseless village taking Imperial fire!
I'm with you, Edie. Let's go lend a hand.
And a few rockets while we're at it.
I'm in.
If you all say so, I'll go too.
Well, what about you, Homer? You're the last holdout here.
I'm not holding out on anything. I was just checking. Besides, do you really think I'd say no to conditions this grim?
Oh, Homer. So pretty. So broken. Anyway, Okay, that settles it. The six of us head into the village and buy them some time. Needless to say, leading the charge will be yours truly, Edie Nelson!
I guess that makes us Squad 7, the Edie Detachment.
The Edie Detachment! Marvelous! Let no one say you're completely useless, Homer! All right, Edie Detachment, we march! Here's the situation, darlings. We'll begin the operation now. Squad 7 Edie Detachment, move out!
Galleon units here? We didn't get any intel about this.
Oh, hush you. It's not like we're here by choice either. But we're not about to let you lowlifes hurt these people while we're around. If it were up to me, I'd have been back at Papa Largo's side hours ago. If anything happens to him while I'm not there, you'll hear from me, sweetie.
I didn't choose this either. There's been far too much killing already. The slaughter at Marbury. War is cruelly casual in stealing good men's lives. I want nothing to do with it. But this war will not be ended through our inaction. So I'll fight, too, to put an end to the needless sacrifice of so many innocents.
You got it, hon!
Yes, right away.
Taking action now.
You can depend on me.
Look, there's a dark hair with him. You're in the way of progress. It's a mistake of history, you oily scum are still around.
She had a dream. A dream that stood fast, even in a Galaga rocked by war, plagued by bigotry. She dreamed of making a world where Darksons lived in peace and equality with everyone. Well, her dream is my dream now. And I will fight for it with my life, for as long as prejudice and violence reign.
And you won't fight alone. I took up this gun to defend the small, to protect the weak. If ignorant tyrants aim to harm them, I'll take aim as well. And if you think I'll hesitate to pull the trigger, try me.
Honey.
is yours to use. Enemy spotted. Begins. New prey sighted. New prey sighted. Nothing personal. Sweet dreams.
Taking the stage. Why should I enjoy seeing dirt? You're a savior. Why should I enjoy seeing dirt? Taking the stage. You're ready for my close-up. What? I can't! No! Get ready! That's what you get! Why should I enjoy seeing dirt? I'll do my very best.
can depend on me. I've located the enemy. Going.
About 80% complete and counting. No civilian casualties so far.
Things are going well.
I guess you're just that good.
Oh, Homer, you're so perceptive. As long as you all keep following my orders, we'll make it through this, no problem. Now hang in there, darlings. It won't be long now.
Roger that, sweetie.
Understood. Leave it to us.
Roger. I'll do what I can.
Honey.
rage. I hope you're ready for my close-up.
All the villagers are out safe. Now we just have to keep up a front as we pull out.
This is the medic! Repeat! This is the medic! Come in! If anyone can hear me, respond! Please!
Wait! There's an incoming wireless signal.
Another of her panic attacks.
I haven't told her off nearly enough. There's so much left to rub in her face. She can't die. No, it's just not. No!
Get a hold of yourself, Edie.
I'm sorry, Miss Edie. I shouldn't have hit you like that. But you're in command right now. If you lose your cool, then the whole detachment's finished. Please, just calm down. We're all with you on this. Tell us what to do. We'll do everything we can to back you up. You go help Miss Rosie.
Homer.
There should be an opening in the enemy's perimeter south of here.
If any of those nasty tanks are in the way, I'll be happy to blow them right up, hon.
I'm not the buddy-buddy type, but you have my support.
We'll hold things down here. You go take care of Rosie.
Guys, suppose so. If you're also insistent, I'll go help her at once. I trust you all can handle this, lovelies. Oh, and Homer?
Hmm? What is it, Missy?
My little thank you for earlier. Savor it, darling.
That's our Edie. Now, order me around. We're awaiting your orders.
All right, listen up. It's a two-front defend and rescue mission. Squad 7 Edie Detachment, get back to work! Taking the stage!
Nicely done, Miss Edie.
Now, quickly! Rosie is waiting for you.
All in good time, darling. You all be careful, too!
Well, that's a relief, Miss Edie. You must be glad to see Miss Rosie safe.
What? Why ever should I care what happens to that horrible ogre of a woman?
We prevented any casualties on this end as well. Truly a stunning success.
And the puppy's safe. Yay.
Goodness, Marina, when did you... You are a wonder.
And now we can finally go home! I'm coming, Largo! Wait up for me, honey!
We all did pretty well out there.
Everyone, you were all... I mean, thank you. I'm proud as a peacock to have commanded the Edie Detachment, darlings! As a reward, I'll give you all a song! That number Rosie sang for Isara. I hate to say it, but it's a wonderful piece. So as the true star of Squad 7, I took it upon myself to add it to my repertoire.
Ooh, I'd like to hear.
Then listen up. This one goes out to you with all my heart and soul, darlings.
Ah! Head exploding! Oh, I've taken headshots that hurt less!
This pushes the limit of the human audible sound range.
Such beautiful flowers everywhere. And there, my sweet departed granny. My left eye... My left eye!
Carl, my ears are ringing. I'll
always love. War is hell.
Marco! I never wanted to go like this.
I've heard sweeter song from an elk shot through the lung.
Overwhelmed by the moving power of my angelic voice? Speak up, darlings, don't be shy, though your response is certainly dynamic.
Oh, at last, the sweet embrace of sleep.
Well, if you all insist, here's an encore! Through the enemy line there.
Please hurry, Miss Edie. Miss Rosie is fading fast.
I know. I'm not ready for her to sell the farm yet either. Rather close. Any longer and we'd have been too late.
Thank goodness we weren't. I'm just glad to see both you and Rosie are safe.
It was touch and go for a while, but we managed to avoid casualties here as well.
Whew. All's well that ends well, right?
All except that deadweight woman, you mean. The trouble we went through for her.
Come on now, Miss Edie. What happened to... She can't die. No!
What? I never! Homer! I never said anything of the sort.
Oh, really? Sure sounded like it to me.
I heard it too.
And me three.
Yep.
Well, all right. I suppose I do have a modicum of respect for her accomplishments. When she sang before Isara's grave, I'll admit, I was touched. You could feel her heart in every note. The tears welled up and just didn't stop. To really sing with all one's heart, it's simple enough to say, but... I want to sing that way, to sing that song. I couldn't help but feel that.
Wow.
So I've been practicing it. I can tell you now that my version puts Rosie's to shame. And she needs to be alive to know shame. I need those hot, salty tears, darlings.
So that's why you flew into a panic?
If your version's so good, let's hear it.
Yes, I'd love to hear you sing it, Edie.
Yep.
Absolutely not!
What? Why not?
As the star of Squad 7, my performances are to be pined for. No handouts, you moochers. Maybe, just maybe, if you perform just a bit better, I'll reconsider.
What a letdown.
Not this time, darling whipping boy. If you really want to hear it, get that whip to cracking. Hup-to, soldier!